If you are in the mood for a bit of a giggle or, in fact, an out-and-out belly laugh, you may want to head over to the Good Theater and catch the last production of their season, A Comedy of Tenors. And I'm joined today by Brian Allen and Stephen Underwood, who are sort of the heart and soul of the Good Theater, shall we say.
Indeed.
And both bringing this production as the season closes. Brian, tell us first, welcome. Tell us first a little bit about the show, which is getting rave reviews.
The show's just really, really fun and funny. Ken Ludwig, the author, wrote one of the best-known farces called Lend Me a Tenor, and he took four characters from that show and wrote a whole new play about them that's set a couple years later, and it's set in Paris in 1936, and there's a lot of mistaken identity and a lot of just craziness that ensues in an hour and a half, and it's great fun.
Stephen, you play Tito, the main character.
Yes.
Tell us a bit about him, and I gather this all takes place in one hotel suite,
yeah,
is that correct?
Yeah, hotel suite. Yeah, Tito is an aging tenor who is just having a little late life identity crisis, and he also plays another character, so I don't want to tell you much about this, the way it's all structured, but in Act Two, there's just kind of running in and out, changing costumes and becoming one character and back to the other, and the cast is just superb in terms of how everybody's working together, and it just kind of feels like we got the perfect cast for this.
Oh my gosh, totally, totally, and they're so fun.
When you see the production or see video of the production, there is a lot of physical comedy and physicality to this. I would imagine doing this night after night. How are you feeling as we're coming down the back stretch?
I've come up to speed with it, but certainly like the night or two before we opened, I just thought, what have I gotten myself into? Because you barely know your lines, you're not making the costume changes, you don't feel like you're funny, you haven't seen it in front of been in front of an audience, and then you have a dress rehearsal, then you open on Wednesday, and then we have reviewers on Thursday, which is really unfair because in bigger productions they'll run for previews for two or three weeks where you work out the bugs.
Right.
But surprisingly, Wednesday it was happening, and then we just got off to a roaring start, and now that I kind of know is like running a little mini decathlon on and off stage, I've just paced myself, and it's a whole lot of fun.
You two have been collaborating around the Good Theater for a very, very long time.
We have.
And we were talking just before this segment about this being the final production of this season, but that doesn't mean you get to sit around and read good books and drink tall drinks. You've got lots going on. Tell us about what's up for the summer and then next season.
We're touring some of our smaller shows this summer. My one-man show I'm working on again, because we're doing that in the fall, and Steve's one-man show is getting done, and Love Letters and Love Loss and What I Wore, those are all happening in places this summer. And then next year is going to be our 17th season, and we're doing five main stage shows, including three shows that were just on Broadway. So there's a lot of planning and stuff to do. It's going to be an exciting summer and hopefully another exciting year at Good Theater in the fall.
It just keeps getting better and better is what I gather.
It seems to, yeah. It's been a great 16 years and hard to believe. But we're excited.
When you're doing a show like this one that relies so heavily on comedy and the physicality of it, how important is it to have that audience there to sort of fuel you as actors?
Oh, it's vital.
It helps a lot. And they provide the rhythm of the piece in terms of where they're laughing or where they're reacting. And I think the main thing about when you go, oh, it's farce, it's comedy, but basically, I think John Cleese said something about, unless you can believe that that person under that pressure would respond like that, if you play it for laughs, it's just being goofy. But if you play it in the truth of someone having this close to being melting down over whatever is at stake, it makes it real. Mm-hmm. And it's nice to every night try to check in with, am I being honest about what this character and this other character are going through in the arc of their story, or are you going, oh, this is a funny line and they're going to laugh? Because you have to stay in touch with the truth of the pressure of that moment, and it's really fun to just fine-tune every night.
Talk a little bit about the ensemble that's doing this, because they are all on stage quite a bit in one setting, so it really is relying on the expertise of those actors.
Yes, and we have a great cast. There are seven people in the cast, and about half of them are new to Good Theater, which is always exciting to add new faces to our family of actors and performers, and some diehard stalwarts like Steve and Kathleen Kimball and Paul Haley, who've done a lot of shows for us. And everybody gets along. Usually when we do a show, everybody wants to just get out of there as soon as it's over because it's been a long day. Mm-hmm. And this crowd, they hang out in the dressing room and we can't get rid of them. It's like, go home, you know. So everybody's having a good time. Everybody's having a really good time, and our audiences are just loving this. It's so much fun.
And tickets are still available?
Yes, we still have tickets, and we play through the 29th.
I was just going to say that, so folks can either go to your website or go to our website for more information.
But they are
like
going fast, which is nice. So it was nice to
great. Well, thank you for joining us. Keep up the great work, and we look forward to next season as well.
Thanks. Good to see you.
It's very nice to see both of you, and we will be right back.